I'm Pastor George Borghardt, and this is another Higher Things video short. Happy birthday, Higher Things. We're going to talk to one of our former registrants and find out what happened with them. That's the subject of today's Higher Things video short. Like, subscribe, ring the bell, get the app, donate. And you know when you're doing a video, hit record. Like our videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel, ring the bell for notifications, get our app. It's available on all the major platforms. And donate a tax-deductible gift. Go to higherthings.org and hit that gift button. Keeps us putting the gospel into the ears of youth all over the world. And we need this gospel in these dark times. Oh, it's reunion time. I know we feel like we've done this before because we just did and I didn't hit record. But Alayna Brandt is a Lutheran school teacher in Grand Rapids, Michigan, and a former registrant. Dire things. And I had my memory redone that you 2010 was your first conference. Is that given?
Correct. It was the one in at Vanderbilt.
That's given.
Was given?
That's
yeah.
Given.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that
and,
was the one.
And after that, tell me what you did in Higher Things.
Sure. So after that, I was a CCV for a couple of years, and then I've been a CCV manager for a couple, and then last year was my first year as the entertainment coordinator.
So you went to Higher Things conferences as a youth, and then you volunteered for the group in college, and then we liked you so much that we put you to work for free managing the college students, and now you make our lives entertaining.
It's been a lot of fun.
All right, so this and now you're a Lutheran school teacher. Oh, that makes me so happy. Grand Rapids, Michigan. So what does Higher Things mean to you?
Yeah, Higher Things has been such a blessing in my life. When I started as a high schooler, I didn't realize the impact that it would have on my life. But my first conference that I went to, I met up with a church from Millscott, Illinois that I had never met. I didn't know anybody that I was going with. But it turns out I still keep in contact with those people. And through that, understood what a blessing it was to be surrounded by like-minded youth. Even as a high school student, I mean, high schoolers, you know, you're trying to figure out what you want to do with your life, how God is going to use you. And Higher Things gave me so much more knowledge and understanding of the Lutheran faith, always being reminded through different plenary sessions and speakers and things like that, just of the gifts that are given to us in our baptism, in the Lord's Supper. And then the fellowship that was provided with so many people that I've met, that's been such a blessing. Is so many of my even close friends today I met through Higher Things. And even though we only see each other once a year, that has been such a blessing. And it's something I look forward to every year.
So I was going to ask you how it impacted your life, but it sounds like you already beat me to that.
Yeah, yes,
you know what I mean? Yes. So it sounded like it was very important to you to find out that there were a lot of people who believed exactly like you, so I'm going to vary up what I was going to ask you and just simply say, there seems to be a reoccurring sort of theme that folks think that youth ministry has to be done a certain way, that it has to involve a cool person. Like, imagine my hair longer. Imagine me with a guitar. Yeah. Imagine me cool. Now that is impossible, but you're gone too far now, Pastor, but you know what I'm saying? And that's not what you experienced in HT. How did that sort of, give me a little bit of that. I know that wasn't what I was planning on asking you, but give me a little bit of that.
Yeah. Yeah. I think it was so encouraging to find other people where you could say, oh, my favorite hymn is, you know, 941. and just to be able to have these different in-depth discussions with other people your own age was something that I wasn't necessarily experiencing, you know, on my day-to-day life. But then through this conference and, you know, trying to put a finger on exactly what it is when you meet somebody who you have the same morals and the same values and you believe the same things, it's a bond that you really can't describe. And, I think that's why with my friendships with people from Higher Things, we just understand the importance of, you know, the liturgy and, reading God's word and understanding the confessions. And I think that just bonds you on a deeper level that you don't understand until you experience it.
So like they gave me questions, but we're gonna scrap them. Let's have some fun. All right, I'm gonna come back to one of them, but I think it's very important that you have come back to Jesus a couple of times.
Yeah,
that youth ministry for you, that your period of time as a high school youth wasn't just, you know, let's have pizza, let's play Xbox, let's play the PS4. It wasn't just that. Can you give me sort of the role of Christ and being challenged in your in your Christian sort of formation as a young person?
Sure. Yeah, definitely. I think that was huge because Higher Things is a lot of fun. I mean, as the entertainment coordinator, it's amazing to get to plan these great things. But what's more important is there's this depth that comes with this, with these conferences, because high school students can handle so much more. You know, they take AP calculus and AP history, all these classes, and yet we think they can't handle heavy scripture, heavy theology. And that was such a blessing to be able to have these conversations that, you know, remind us that it's more than just getting together and having fun, but it's understanding what your baptism means and being able to talk with pastors and learn more about different hard topics. I mean, you know, high schoolers today are bombarded by so much. The devil is having a field day. But yet, by being able to return to scripture and God's word and this community that also builds you up and reminds you that you're not alone, we're all connected here, that's the comfort that really we find through Higher Things.
I like that it's everything that it's not like we're trying to have a mountaintop experience. It's that this is what's going on in my parish. Only in only now I know that it's not just me that likes a mighty fortress. You know what I mean? It's not just me that it's okay to chant, it's okay to sing. You know what I mean?
Definitely.
So you grew up in HT every year. You were attendee, volunteer, staff member, and now you're fun. Now Alayna brings the fun. She brings the fun to the conferences. What's that experience been like? Just sort of.
Yeah, so wonderful. When I remember my first conferences that I attended just as an attendee, I thought the CCBs, I thought they were the coolest. I wanted them to notice, like I wanted to say hi to them. And if you are a high school student or a college student and you apply to be a CCB, it's so fun to attend. I think it is even more fun to get the behind the scenes look at how the conference is run. And for me, transitioning from an attendee to a CCB, one thing that I loved, and just in general with Higher Things, is it's not only the sessions and the breakaways and the worship that's wonderful, but it's also the debriefing that happens when you're walking back to your dorm or when you're hanging out at 1 a.m. because you should all be sleeping, but you're all talking about infant baptism. Like those discussions that you're able to have, or even, you know, with your pastor, I was had the opportunity to bring my church's youth a couple of years ago, and to be able to sit and hang out with your pastor, like in a dorm room, like that's so fun in the lobby, and able to just get to know the people in your own church even better. So I feel like every step that I've grown in Higher Things, it gets better and better because now even as a staff member, you know, again, you're growing those relationships, you're having amazing conversations about your faith, and you have the opportunity to ask questions with things, but then still get to worship and, sing those praises together.
I love to pass the dorm rooms where the youth groups are all gathered around and they're singing Compline. One of my favorite Higher Things experiences, where we were driving back from a conference and I was tired and it was dark and I wanted them to be quiet. And all of a sudden, one of them starts, "Jesus Christ is the light of the world." And then the rest of them, "The light no darkness can overcome." And then they're like, they're tapping me like, "We're going to do evening prayer now. Will you? And I'm like, yeah. You don't have to ask twice. And suddenly I like you. Okay. Now that's one of my favorite memories. And closing, what's your favorite HT memory?
If you have one? Man, There's so many. Two stick out in my head. One, the first one, when I was a CCV when the conference was at Concordia, Wisconsin in 2014. I'm a Concordia, Wisconsin grad, go Falcons. And that year we sang hymn 941. You know, it's the one that Higher Things says the video of. That is my favorite hymn. We praise you and acknowledge you. And just hearing, being in, you know, the Chapel of Christ Triumphant at CUW and singing that hymn. I play it for my students now. And, you know, I'm like, oh, that's where I went to college. Isn't that so cool? They haven't quite picked up on how cool that is. Not sure why they don't understand that. But just every time I hear it, get chills because of the beauty of not only the music and the surroundings, but the comfort that the words give. So that's one. The other was 2 years ago at Concordia, Wisconsin again, when I was doing entertainment, Vicar Nemec, when he dressed up in his squirrel costume for Chase the Vicar or whatever game that we did. Oh man, seeing him in that squirrel costume, I will never forget that.
So the college volunteers, are those students that apply, and they apply to volunteer at the conference. They're not paid. I think the college, I'm going to get frosty, but I think the college volunteers are just exemplify. We loved paying to go to the conference. We loved the conferences and what we received from the conferences so much that we'll drive across America. We'll find a way. We'll carpool. We'll fly planes, trains, automobiles in order to have an impact on the conference. And those bonds that they have are like huge. So what I love about it is, like, not only do we get to serve young people, mm-hmm. but then we get to teach young people to be leaders and then to lead. Yeah. And then, mm-hmm. and then to serve. And I'm going to don't make me I'm having an allergy attack right now. I'll be all right. All right. So Alayna, thank you. Alayna Brandt is a teacher, a Lutheran school teacher in Grand Rapids. What school?
Our Savior Lutheran.
There it is. Our Savior Lutheran. Hello kids from Our Savior Lutheran. Your teacher is famous. She's a rock star. She is also a former registrant and staff member of Higher Things. And I hope you've seen the impact that this organization, who turns 20 this year, has had. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Happy birthday to Higher Things. This is just one of the many, 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 many stories of young people whose lives have been impacted, not by a little organization, but by the gospel being put into their ears. I'm Pastor George Borghardt, daring to be Lutheran, having a blast while I do it. This has been another Higher Things video short.